bold forester and a chaser of the king's deer. And Eleanor was a fair woman, and Lord Thomas, he loved her dear. Come riddle my riddle, dear mother, he said, and riddle us both as one. Whether I shall marry fair Eleanor, and let the brown girl alone. The brown girl, she has houses and land, fair Eleanor, she has none. Therefore I charge you on my blessing to bring me the brown girl. Befell on a high holiday, as many more did beside. Lord Thomas, he went to fair Eleanor, that should have been his bride. But when he came to fair Eleanor's bower, he knocked there at the ring. But who was so ready as fair Eleanor for to let Lord Thomas in? What news, Lord Thomas, she said, what news hast thou brought unto me? I am come to bid thee to my wedding, and that is bad news to thee. O God forbid, Lord Thomas, she said, that such a thing could be done. I thought to have been thy bride my own self, and you to have been the bride's groom. Come riddle my riddle, dear mother, she said, and riddle it all in one. Whether I should go to Lord Thomas's wedding, or whether I shall tarry at home. There's many that are your friend's daughter, and many that are your foe. Therefore I charge you on my blessing, to Lord Thomas's wedding don't go. There's many that are my friend's mother, if a thousand more were my foe. Betide my life, betide my death, to Lord Thomas's wedding I'll go. She clothed herself in gallant attire, and her merry men all in green. And as they rid through every town, they took her to have been a queen. But when she came to Lord Thomas's gate, she knocked there at the ring. But who was so ready as Lord Thomas to let fair Eleanor in? Is this your bride, fair Ellen, she said, methinks she looks wondrous brown. Thou mightest have had as fair a woman as ever trod on the ground. Despise her not, fair Ellen, he said, despise her not unto me. For better I love thy little finger than all of her whole body. This brown bride had a little penknife that was both long and sharp, and betwixt the short ribs and the long pricked fair Eleanor to the heart. O Christ, now save thee, Lord Thomas, he said, methinks thou looks wondrous one. Thou once used for to look as fresh a colour as ever the sun shined on. Oh, art thou blind, Lord Thomas, she said, or canst thou not very well see? Oh, dost thou not see my own heart's blood runs trickling down my knee? Lord Thomas, he had a sword by his side as he walked about the hall, and he's cut off his bride's head from her shoulders, and he's threw it against the wall. He set the hilt against the ground and the point against his heart. There was never three lovers that ever met, more sooner they did depart. There was never three lovers that ever met, more sooner they